assistant professor at St. Martin's Engineering College. So today we are going to deal with two topics at a time. So first one is modifiers and second one is phrasal verbs. So first let's see about what modifiers are. So modifier, that indicates, it indicates to modify the noun or a verb, okay? So whenever we are going to deal with the modifier, so it generally modifies the complete meaning of the noun or the verb. So it is generally the modifier should be placed before or after the noun. So yeah, it should be placed before or after the noun. So and we have to keep the modifier so as close as possible to the noun. So if it is placed far away from the modifier, then that gives the funny meaning of the sentence actually. So really, it makes the sentence completely funny. So you have to keep in mind to modify the sentence. So keep the modifier as close as possible with the noun actually. So let's go with few of the examples and find out how modifier changes the sentence and how it modifies if it is placed in the correct format. Okay, so first example. So I give chocolates to my students. So I gave chocolates in to my students imported from Germany. So here the modifier is imported from Germany. So keep that aside first and find out what are the nouns in the rest of the sentence. So here the one of the noun is chocolates and students. So when we see the sentence, so if here the modifier is placed in the wrong place. Okay, misplaced modifier we have here. So here, if you keep this sentence aside and see the rest of the sentence. So students imported from Germany. So here, this sentence gives you the meaning, the students imported from Germany. So students cannot be imported from Germany. So that is the funniest meaning here. So here, chocolates are imported from Germany, not the students imported from Germany. So keep that aside. So we have to place the misplaced modifier imported from Germany as close as possible with the correct noun. Okay. So that modifier is intended to modify the correct noun. Okay. It is not intended to modify the noun students. Okay. It is only intended to modify the students. Okay. If you change the sentence, it goes like this. I give chocolates imported from Germany to my students. Okay, this gives the correct meaning of this one. Okay, so let's have the next example actually. So getting ready for the office, the food was eaten by John. Okay, so here getting ready for the office, the food was eaten by John. So this is the sentence what we have now. So here, getting ready for the office is the misplaced modifier. Okay. So here, see the rest of the sentence. So the food was eaten by John. So here, we have, check out the nouns here. The first noun is the food and the John. So here, these two are the nouns. And if you see the sentence, getting ready for the office, the food was eaten by John. The food was eaten by John in a hurry. Okay. So we have this sentence. So here the food cannot be the food cannot get ready for the office. Okay. So John is getting ready for the office. John is the person. John is the one who is getting ready for the office, not the food. Okay. So here this is the misplaced modifier, and keep this in the correct form now. So okay. Getting ready for the office, John ate the food in a hurry. John ate the food in a hurry. Okay, this is how you change the sentence actually. Let's go to the next sentence. The bread was thrown out of the fridge which was broken. Okay, so here the bread was thrown out of the fridge which was rotten. Okay, so if you see this sentence, what is the modifier? So here which was rotten is your modifier. And if you see the rest of the sentence and find out the nouns, so we get the bread and the fridge. So we have two nouns, bread and fridge. So both are nouns here. So if you check out this sentence once, so the fridge cannot be rotten. Okay, so the fridge itself cannot be rotten. Here the bread which was rotten. Okay, so the bread is the one which was rotten, but not the fridge. Okay, so you have to keep the misplaced modifier to the right place actually. So if you change the sentence, the bread which was rotten was thrown out of the fridge. Okay, this is the way to change the misplaced modifier with the correct noun. Okay, here which was rotten is intended to modify the word, modify the noun, the bread. Okay, it is not at all intended to modify the noun fridge. Okay, next let's see the next example here. So here, a guy killed a rat around 7 feet. Okay, sorry. Around 7 feet tall. Okay, so here, a guy killed the rat around 7 feet tall is your sentence. So if you check this sentence out, so the misplaced modifier is 7 feet tall. Around 7 feet tall is your misplaced modifier. And check the rest of the sentence and find out what the nouns available here. Okay, so a guy and the rat. So both are the nouns here, and around 7 feet tall is your misplaced modifier. Okay, so here the around 7 feet tall is the modifier. Around 7 feet tall is intended to modify the noun guy, but it is not intended to modify the noun rat. Okay, so if you change the sentence out, okay, a guy around 7 feet tall, a guy around 7 feet tall killed the rat. Okay, so is here in the first sentence it gives the meaning as the rat which is 7 feet tall. So here rat cannot be 7 feet tall. The boy who is present here is 7 feet tall. Okay, that is what the sentence means actually. In the first sentence it is showing the rat as 7 feet tall. So we should not make it happen like that. So that is the one thing. Next example. Mother gave candy to my friend, which was sweet. So here, if you check it out, what the modifier is. So which was sweet is your modifier. So which is misplaced. So if you check the sentence, if you check the rest of the sentence out, check it out what the modifiers are. The first thing, candy is the noun and my friend is the noun, okay? So who is sweet here? So obviously candy, not the friend actually, okay? So friend can be sweet in other ways, but not in the case of the sweetness, okay? Already we have the noun candy available here, so we have to so this modifier which was sweet is intended to modify the noun candy but not the noun my friend. Okay, if you change the sentence out, okay, mother gave candy which was sweet to my friend. So mother gave candy which was sweet to my friend is your correct modifier. So the misplaced modifier candy which was sweet, so misplaced modifier is intended to modify candy, the noun candy here, not my friend. Okay, not the noun my friend. So this is how you find out how to change the modifier is and how what the modifier actually is and how keep the correct format of this misplaced modifier. Okay, so let's see the other next topic called as phrasal verbs. So what the phrasal verbs are, okay? So phrasal verbs shows you the action because we already have the verb here present in the word itself. So this however shows the action done, okay? So here we have two types of phrasal verbs here. So what they are? So phrasal verb can be of two types, okay? First one, you have a verb plus preposition or adverb. So preposition or adverb in the first format, okay? So here we have a verb which is attached to a preposition or adverb generally, okay? This is the type 1 phrasal verb. And type 2 phrasal verb, we have three elements in this: verb plus preposition or adverb plus preposition or adverb. Okay, so in the first type of phrasal verb we have verb plus preposition or adverb, and in the second format we have three elements in this: verb plus preposition or adverb plus preposition or adverb. Okay, these are the two formats for that. So if you check out what the phrasal verbs are, actually we have very easy phrasal verbs and those are used in our day-to-day life. So what they are? Stand up and sit down. So these come under the phrasal verbs actually. So these are very easy and we don't know that they belong to phrasal verb, but so they are very easy and everybody use them in their daily basis. Okay, if I tell you to stand, So you stand, okay? No need of telling stand up, okay? That the meaning is not at all changing here. Stand up, okay? And sit down, okay? So the meaning is not at all changing here. So if I tell you to stand, you however stand. And if I tell you to sit, you sit, okay? So this up and down here, no need of changing type of, you know, changes in your sentences. So this is very easy type of phrasal verbs actually, okay?